Minasan, konnichiwa. Zamurai Engineer desu. Today, let us go to the next topic, lesson number 5. So, in this lesson, we'll talk about the financial statements. What are they and how they are prepared? There are 4 types of financial statements that we're going to look at. First, we will look into income statement. Next, we'll look into retained earnings statement. Then, we'll go to balance sheet. And the last one, we'll talk about statement of cash flows. Okay? So, what do we need to accomplish in this? What do we have to prepare for in this? First questions. You already know this. This is some sort of review. Net income will result during a time period when? Okay? And if you do not understand, you can repeatedly watch the definition videos that are there in our channel. I repeat, going back to the first question, net income will result during a time period when A, assets exceed liabilities, B, asset exceed revenues, C, expenses exceed revenues, and D, revenues exceed expenses. Okay, so it's very simple. It's very simple. We'll have a net income. We have an income, but we are talking of net income. So net income is actually revenues exceed expenses. Okay. Financial statement. Number one, income statement at the top and retained earnings statement at the bottom of this page. Okay. So we have net income needed to determine the ending balance and retained earnings. So we need to start with income statement, without which we cannot start with the retained earnings statement, because the final value from the income statement is the starting value from the retained earnings statement. So, okay, so notice the relationship of income statement to retained earnings statement. Okay, let us go on the accounts listed under income statement. So the example at the top, we have revenues, which is actually service revenue because we are a service company. Expenses, what are those? Salaries and wages, rent expense, advertising expense, utilities expense, and we can total that expense. So total expenses, we have to subtract it from the service revenue. So revenue minus expenses is our net income. That forms part of our simple income statement for 1 month, for the month of September, which end on September 30. Okay. So next, after that, we'll use that value to start off with the retained earnings statement. So retained earnings before September, there is none because we just started September 1, so zero. Addition of net income, so that is why we need to use the amount calculated on our income statement, which is here is 2,750. These documents are separate. They are just shown here, one on top of the other, because to be able to observe the similarity and the relationship. They are actually different books. There is a book called Income Statement Book and another book, Retained Earnings Statement Book. Okay? We are actually making four books for the four relevant reports called financial statements. Okay? So, and after net income, we have to less the dividends. Okay? So, first, we have to less from the revenues, the expenses, and after which, we have again to less the dividends. Okay? After lessen the dividends, we now have the retained earnings. Okay? And in this case, we have 1,450 is our retained earnings. What is the relationship? On the next financial statement, what is the next financial statement? We have the balance sheet. Okay? Okay? So, as shown here, the top one is the retained earnings statement, and the bottom one is the balance sheet. The balance sheet, take note of the relationship, 1,450 and 1,450 under the stockholder's equity. Okay? So, for the balance sheet, let's look first for the first main title, assets. What are the accounts under the assets? There are four. Cash, account receivable, supplies, equipment, and then total asset. We have a total of $18,050. Okay? And for the liabilities and stockholders' equity, under liability, we have accounts payable, one account. And stockholders' equity, we have common stock, retained earnings. And retained earnings has actually three accounts under it, which are already calculated in the upper portion, which are what? Income statement and retained earnings statements. So, we only put the retained earnings account in the balance sheet. So, total of 1,450. And therefore, we have to add the common stock and retained earnings. The total is 16,450 in this example. And therefore, after which, we can add the accounts payable, 1,600. And therefore, we have what? 18,050, which is the same as the value under the assets. Okay? So, we have a good balance sheet. What is this relationship with the last? The last financial statement. On the upper portion, we have the balance sheet. On the lower portion, we have the fourth financial statement, which is the statement of cash flow. Okay. We need what? The cash. We need the cash. Okay. Okay. That is the retained cash. Okay. So, cash on hand. Cash at the end of the period. That is the cash that we needed. Okay? And what are the details of this? Okay, first, we have cash receipts from revenues. Okay? If you will recall, 3,500. And cash payments for expenses, we have 1,950. And you notice that here we are using parentheses to indicate negative. If the number is written inside the parentheses, that is negative. That must be negative. And those numbers without parentheses, those are positive. Take note of how we are dealing with financial statements. Okay? Note, 1,950 is under or inside the parentheses, so that is negative. So, 3,300 minus this amount is 1,350. Okay? Again, the next one is cash flow from investing activities. So purchase of equipment, we invested on equipment, so 7,000. That is what? The computer, okay? 7,000. So it decreases our cost, so therefore it is inside the parentheses, okay? Next one is cost flows from. So all of the main subtitle here is called cash flow. Cash flow from, cash flow payment, cash flow from, cash flow from, okay? Cash flow from financing activities, okay? Sale of common stock, okay? So that is financing activities. There are stockholders who buy common stock, so we have sale of common stock, $15,000. Then payment of cash dividends, that must be negative, so that is written inside parentheses. So 15,000 minus 1,300, that is 13,700. Okay? Payment of cash dividends is 1,300. Okay? And therefore, net increase in cash is 8,050. We have 8,050 because we have to total 1,350 minus 7,000 and positive 13,700. If you total this out, you will get 8,050. And net increase in cash is that amount. Cash at the beginning of the period, we doesn't have any cash because we just started this month. And cash at the end of the period, therefore, is the same because we did not have any increase. We increased 8,050, but we did not start from anything, zero. So the same, okay? The same cash at the end of the period. Okay, take note of another thing in this financial statement. The totals are written with two lines under the number. So under the number 18,050, there are two lines written under it. So it is a common practice to do that to indicate the totals. Okay? Note, income statements are reports of profitability of the company's operations over a specific period of time, from this day up to this day. That is how income statement have to be recorded. Okay? It lists revenues first, followed by expenses. So those example formats are actually common and format. That is already a format. Okay? Shows net income or net loss, if ever. So net loss, yeah, we'll have what? We'll have parentheses. Okay? Does not include investment and dividend transaction. So do not ever record investment and dividend transaction in the income statement. Transaction between stockholders and the business. It's nothing of that matter. Okay? Alternative terminology, the income statement is sometimes called statement of operations or sometimes earnings statement or profit and loss statement. They are being called in United Kingdom as profit and loss statement. In the United States, they are called income statement. And some other parts of the world, statement of operations. In India, they are called profit and loss statement, and so on. Okay? So, how about retained earnings statement? They are reports that changes in retained earnings for a specific period of time. So, both this income statement and retained earnings statements are for a specific period of time. Okay? The time period is the same as that covered by the income statement. If 1 month, 1 month. Okay? Same initial date, same final date. Okay? It cannot be different starting and end date should be the same. Okay. Information provided indicates the reason why retained earnings increased or decreased during the period. So those transaction and information that increase or decrease the earnings are belonging to this statement. Okay? So balance sheet. These are the reports of assets, liabilities, and stockholders' equity at a specific date. It is not period of time. It is specific. What is my asset today? You can do that. What is my asset on this date? Okay. What is my liabilities on this date? So it is for a specific date. It is quite different from income statement and statement of retained earnings. List assets at the top, followed by liabilities, and then followed by stockholders' equity. Total assets must be equal to the total liabilities and stockholders' equity. That is our accounting equation. It's a snapshot of the company's financial condition at a specific moment in time. It is usually 1 month or month end or year end. That is the company's condition at the end of the year, at the end of the month. So that's about balance. How about the statement of cash flows? There are information on the cash receipts and payments for a specific period of time. Another report for a period of time. Okay? It's a period of time. Answers the following. Where did cash came from? What was cash used for? What was the change in the cash balance? What is the cash remaining? Okay. Hint. The income statement, retained earnings statement, and statement of cash flows are all for a period of time. That's what I have said. Whereas the balance sheet is for a point in time, for a specific time only. Okay. Now that is the main difference. Financial statement. Question number two. Which of the following financial statements is prepared as of a specific date? Specific date. Therefore, we just explained from the previous page. The answer is balance sheet. Because all the other three are prepared for a period of time. Specific date is not a period of time. This is a period of time. This is a specific day. Okay. Okay. We have here an article for you to answer. You can post the video here and read this article. I will let you do it, and you can do it for a long time, as long as you understand the problem, and then you will have to answer this question. Okay. Why might a company stockholders be interested in its environmental and social performance? Well, that is the question. Anyway, I will put the question on the comment box and pin this question at the top of the comment section so that all of you would be able to read the question and answer this question properly. Okay, so this is for you to answer. And this is for our practice. Problem. So we'll have practice, and actually okay, we'll stop our discussion and put another video on the next on the financial statement. Thank you. This again, Dr. Epi, Samurai Engineer at your service.